there's so many different characters that are in all different places, inside the park, outside. How was it to kind of balance that, like, the different stories, but also be able to, throughout the season, have characters in and out interact with each other?
It's funny because on a purely production level, it was so great because more often than not, you're just telling a story with two people. And shooting scenes with two people are much easier than shooting scenes with seven people. Like a family dinner scene can take you 9 days. Storytelling, that was the challenge because that can be a tired, you know, that can get tired fast. You know, I love Game of Thrones as much as anybody, but you do reach about 0.8 episodes in and you're like, oh, these two again, you know? It's a challenge. We played a lot with people taking refuge in new places to mix up the combinations. We played a lot with an opportunity where Lex from the outside and Jake from the inside do have the ability to come face to face in a government-sanctioned space. So we play with a lot of different concepts for how to mix and match of it.
Of those that you're talking about, what was your favorite mix and match? Like, what was your favorite, like, interaction between characters?
Oh, that's good, that's good. It was, I mean, I can't say it because I did it away, but there is a great moment when Jake, who's played by Chris Wood, walks right smack into the middle of Teresa's storyline at a very inopportune moment in the pregnancy, let's say. So, thankfully he's a cop and he's well trained.
For any kind of emergency.
Exactly.
Okay.
He's prepared.
So we were trying to figure out how do you bring love to the apocalypse? That's how we've been.
I love that question. How do you bring love to the apocalypse? Do you realize that that is one of the things that draws me to these stories? And I don't know what that says about me, but it's something like, I mean, I watched the what's that Roland Emmerich movie with Emmy Rossum and Jake Gyllenhaal and the End of the World, and my favorite part of that movie is when they're trapped in the library together. There's something, it's the Breakfast Club syndrome, I call it, when disparate people from disparate circumstances are put into the same situation and asked to either get along or survive or not kill each other, and from that always, I think, is an opportunity for unconventional love, and I think that's one of the reasons I like this kind of storytelling so much.
Are there any characters, and not giving specifics, but where like their death is just was off the table? I mean, you have kids in the pilot, they come face to face. I mean, was there anyone like at the beginning you're like, no, we're not going to go there? Or was everything pretty much open?
No, pretty much everything was fair game. I mean, I don't think any of us were excited to watch an 11-year-old bleed out from the inside, you know? So definitely I think we tried to manage not getting ourselves too close to that threat, but the threat does exist, and I think that's part of the tension. I'm trying to think, is there anybody that we felt like we just couldn't kill? No. Yeah. Pretty much everyone had a target on their back from the beginning.
What's your favorite relationship in the show? Like, I love Jake and Katie. I love, you know, Lex and Jana. There's so many, and even Jake and Lex, there's so many great ones. Yeah. What's your favorite?
Do you know, I really enjoyed, and it's kind of the almost you could call it the boring one, you know, because it's not rooted in sexual chemistry or sexual tension or love or anything. But Lex and Lomers, I really like their dynamic because she's so fierce and he is so proud, and he doesn't trust her, but he knows she's in charge, and she doesn't really want to have to need him, but she does. And so much happens over the course of the 13 episodes. It takes them, they get deep, and they then get embroiled in some really intense conflict with each other. Just a very powerful couple in that way. And then, you know, I mean, just from the gooey girl perspective, which, you know, guys, I love that stuff. Honestly, like, Jake and Katie, like, they're, that's my breakfast club, you know? That's the two people trapped in the hospital, you know? What's going to happen, you know? And I do love that as well.
So Matt and Chris talked about all the research that they did.
Yes.
And how terrified it was.
Yes.
Is that true of you as well?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, actually, the one thing that the research confirmed for me is that these people do really know what they're doing. They really do. And that was very encouraging because you kind of have the sense of like, oh, that mystery virus is going to pop up and everyone's going to say, well, we're all dead and, you know, run for the hills. But there's so many layers of, you know, of to local government, state government, the CDC, universities, just, you know, I mean, the military and the medical training. There is a lot of intelligence and preparedness that has already been set in motion, you know, for anything like this to happen. Like, the CDC are the ones that they bring in later, you know. So before you even have to get to the CDC, you're in pretty good hands. So that was a relief.